She was like, this bitch. I legit thought when I walked back through the curtain that I was going to be fired. And Vince is laughing hysterically.
Welcome everyone to Ring the Bell. This is DS, and today we are here with the Chick Buster, the NXT Season 3 winner, the Divas Champion, Kaitlyn Celeste Bonin.
That was quite the introduction.
I practiced it really hard.
I feel like we could just cut it now.
I'm so excited I'm finally meeting you. I heard great things about you from Chris Riddle, our best friend.
Dude, because of Chris, I've met so many cool people, and you are now one of them. I was very taken back by your outfit. It's like, it's incredible.
Your hair kind of matches how extra
everything is. Yeah, this is like the most extra.
We have top five fan-voted best Kaitlyn moments.
God. Okay, I'm ready.
Let's get right into it. So let's go to our first moment.
Okay.
Let's find out who it's going to be. Congratulations, Kaitlyn!
You winning the season 3 of NXT.
Okay, so full transparency. I think you always go into something like preparing yourself for the worst. The whole entire season, I was like expecting just to get eliminated like any second, because I debuted with zero experience. Like the first time I ever wrestled was on like live TV on NXT. My two options were to like walk away and not take the opportunity, or just to be like, this is like my oh shit method was just to do it and see what happens. And like that was my entire like NXT mentality. And so when I made it to the finals, I was like, what is this, like, am I being punked? Like, I owe so much of it to Vicky Guerrero, because she was like my pro, but she was a massive heel on TV. So like that was such a gift for me, because she treated me so bad on the show that like people felt bad for me. I was this huge underdog. So like I attribute so much of winning to her, but I'm also like, I really had to pull some stuff like deep down from inside me to compete as hard as I did. And I there was a lot of really embarrassing moments on that show.
You're so handsome.
And so like to like have the strength to like still show my face after that. So like I truly like when they were like, okay, when I won, I was like, I kind of had some stuff in my head. It was like, if I win, I'll say this. But when that happens in the moment and it's live and everyone's just like, I was so like shocked, and I don't even remember what I said. I didn't think that was a good, like that would be a moment, but it truly, like, it was one of the most like pivotal moments for my career.
Yeah, absolutely. So you think the secret of you winning was?
It was a combination of things. Like, I had so much support from like all the girls on the show, like Naomi and AJ, and like, and I learned so much from them on the fly, because I had never wrestled before, never been on TV before. I told myself like, okay, I'm just gonna have this like, I have nothing to lose mentality, and like, I still kind of am like that now. So it's like, it's working for me.
I love it. Let's move to our second moment.
Okay.
It is.
Oh my God.
Eva, no. Oh man! Eva eliminated. Kaitlyn.
Here is your winner and number one contender for the Divas Championship. Kaitlyn.
Your accidental win of the number one contendership.
It's so hard to watch, because it's like in that moment I was like, oh my God, I'm gonna get fired. That reaction from Layla was 100% real. She was like, this bitch. So Raw's live. So there was like a saying, like, nothing can ever go wrong on live TV, because like once it happens, it's out there. It happens. You have to go with it. So like everybody knows, or most people know, that matches are predetermined. So we knew going into that, like, I wasn't supposed to win. Eve and I were very close at that point. We became much, much closer after we were in a run for the title together. But there was a different spot that was supposed to happen. It was supposed to clothesline her over. She was going to catch herself. And then I was going to be eliminated. So in that moment, she said, you got to hit me harder. And like, this is like, I was like, okay. So I just hit the, I JBL'd her over the ropes. And I hit her so hard that she slipped and fell. I legit thought when I walked back through the curtain that I was going to be fired. And that was like right on the cusp of like the Divas getting like more opportunities. So I was like, oh my God, like I f***ed everything up. And so like I walk back and Vince is laughing hysterically. They were laughing hysterically.
That's nice.
And I was like, is it like an evil laugh, or like, and so I got so much like, there was a lot of people who like thought I didn't deserve it because I was still so new and like I hadn't like proved myself or whatever. It's such a weird industry. Yeah. But there was also a lot of people that were like, congratulations, like this is your opportunity, like take it.
What was the first thing that Eve and Layla told you?
Eve was crying. It was just so like, in that moment, there was so much adrenaline and so many like things running through all of our heads. So I couldn't really get a read on Layla. Like, her and I were, like, never super close.
Okay.
So Eve and I were very, very close. And that led to us becoming... She was, like, such a mentor for me. Like, because we had such a long, like, run together when I won the title from her. But she was always incredible. Incredible. Like, AJ and I would say that she was, like, a Disney princess because she always looked gorgeous. She was so smart, always, like, composed. Like, I have nothing but amazing things to say about her. And even now, like, she's... I love Eve. She's amazing.
Yeah. So speaking of unplanned moment happening.
So two so far.
We're going to go to planned moment not happening. And
right.
It is. It's almost like an alternate universe.
God.
When you betrayed AJ to join Divas of Doom.
I barely remember this because everything happened so fast that day and the script changed like a million times and like nothing really like happened from it. I remember that day. I was so nervous and like, but I really felt, I was like, okay, this is like a huge opportunity for me. And like, and I know Beth and Natty were so excited, and it was still during the time where like, all the like skinny like Barbie looking divas were like on top, and like I was kind of in between. I was like pretty muscular. That's where the hybrid diva came from. I felt like a hybrid of like the two types of like divas there were. And so I was like so excited to finally like be under like Beth and Natty's wing and like this thing, and it didn't happen. So but honestly, that's the nature of the business. I mean, I can't tell you how many storylines like I pitched and like they got given to somebody else, or and then it just happens. Like the writers see something for somebody and they're like, okay, you, and it's always about being in the right place at the right time. And so I look at that and I'm like, okay, it just wasn't meant to be.
I see.
So that's crazy though. I barely remember that.
Fans
I'm like,
are
that was
obsessed
me.
With this. This is like the alternate universe that people like always.
It really
think
is
about.
Because AJ and I were so close and like and I it's crazy. Yeah. Like I was not expecting that. Wow.
Let's go to third moment.
Sometimes they say fools rush in, but here comes Kaitlyn. And it's champion.
And it is you winning the Divas Championship from Eve Torres.
I loved this match, first of all, because even I had like worked so hard, like together, and we were given so much opportunity, so many like good segments, and like one of my most incredible matches I ever had was like a live event. It was not televised. It was a one-on-one against Eve at Madison Square Garden, and it was like the most insane thing for me. She was leaving, like this was her like when she basically gave me the title, or like, you know, we had a, like a really intense like storyline and stuff, but it was so important to her to like leave the right way and like say like, here, I'm passing this torch on to you. Like the title was like a symbol for that.
Okay.
So I was so grateful because there was so many times where like the writers or Vince or whatever were like, oh, we'll do it like this. Or would you like this? She was like, no, we're going to do it. Because this was the 20th anniversary of Raw in Houston, Texas, which is my hometown.
Yeah.
And as a babyface, you never win the title in your hometown.
Never.
You just get the shit beat out of you in your hometown. So like it was so emotional for me because like I knew how hard I had worked and like I felt like I had proven myself so many times, and like Eve was leaving and I was so honored that like I was getting the title from Eve and like she was, and then that was her, she was retiring, and and to not only like for it to happen on such a like big episode of Raw, it was my hometown, and like all of my friends and family were there, so it was like I really tried that day to take everything in and like remember it and process it, because it was so meaningful. This I expected this because this was like such a big moment. Yeah,
I mean, it's a pivotal moment because Eve Torres retired, and then that was a time where Beth was leaving, Kelly left, so
it was kind of scary. It was like, what's gonna happen? It's like it was like the next era of us.
So what was the responsibility like?
It was immense because we still weren't there yet where they were trusting the women with like really long segments, and we were getting there. They were giving us more and more and more and more because we were earning it. But it was like once Eve was leaving, like it was like, okay, am I still gonna have this opportunity? Because she was so amazing. It was like huge shoes to fill. I had like an awesome run, but it was not as like action-packed as I had hoped, and I think like when Eve left, it kind of like did die down a little bit, and because Eve was like a favorite, like Vince loved her, everybody loved her, so I felt like this like really big responsibility to step up, and I don't know. And then it was also like when I had the title, that's kind of when Total Divas got introduced, and it kind of overshadowed everything that was going on in the women's division that wasn't associated with Total Divas. So it was like a combination of things, but I do think like it was necessary stepping stone to everything that was coming for the women. So I'm still so proud of it. Yeah.
So next moment is one of my all-time favorite matches of all time.
She's got a virtual. Oh! Yeah. And AJ gonna turn it out of there. The official. Oh, yeah.
It is payback match.
Yeah, dude.
With you and AJ.
Gives me the chills. Like, so we built up to this for months, right? And so we were best friends. And so to me, like, the best matches happen between people that truly care about each other because it's not just about you. Like, you're telling a story together. And so, like, it was so meaningful for us to have this match. We had a long match on a pay-per-view, and our time was up. And so we had the ref saying, like, go home, go home, go home. And we said no. And it's because, like, it's moments like that are unexplainable. Like, we could, like, the energy from the crowd was, like unlike anything that we had ever felt. And it was, like, they were, like, this is awesome chance. And, like, it was so cool to be in that match with her, for her to win this title like that. And then after us having such a, like, emotional storyline, everyone was so invested in it. And, like, this is my most favorite match of all time. And I don't know if, like, I'll ever top it. But, like, I mean, there's, you know, there's different scenarios and different things that I'm sure will come. But, like, it is truly one of the most, like, emotionally invested things, like,
absolutely,
for me. Like, we had so much skin in the game. You know what I mean? Like, we were so, so invested. And, like, we had gone through so much together, like, trying to, like, break down the glass ceilings and stuff. And it was, like, it was, like, one of my most, not just in wrestling, just, like, in life in general, like, one of my most favorite moments ever. Yeah.
So one thing I really like about you and AJ is when you spear her, she looked like she's just
She was, like, the only person I, like, so the thing with, like, my style of wrestling is, like, strong and, like, it's simple and it's not, like, fancy and shit. Yeah. So, like, a spear is something I can give to anybody, right? So, but with her, she would take it she would, like, fold in half. So, like she loved taking it, too, because she was so good at selling.
Yeah.
And so, like, there was one spear where we did the contract signing for Money in the Bank. Yeah. She literally folded in half and, like, flipped upside down. And it was, like, I was, like, how did you do that? Like, but it was, like, she was so into it. Like, it was, like.
So how did that become your finisher, spear?
Everything that I did on TV was so trial and error because, like, I literally learned everything I knew on TV or in live events. The match at Madison Square Garden was right before the Raw, where I won the title.
Oh, okay.
So it was, like, the weekend before. Uh-huh. So Arn Anderson, he was like, you need to wrestle like Beth. You're strong. You're big. Like, he was like, you're whatever. And he would, and it was so hard being new, like, being able to say, like, hey, this is how I'm going to wrestle, so you have to sell for me like this. So it was really hard. But he's the one who was like, you're going to use the spear in this match. And it was like, the crowd popped huge.
So good.
And, like, then that's literally, I had done it one night before I used it in the title match. And then that's how it became my finisher.
All right, let's go to our last moment.
From Houston, Texas, Kaitlyn.
You hear the universe here with you still. Bad hand of me again.
Your return to WWE.
Oh, the main. I did not even think about this. Yeah. Dude, this was so cool for me because, number one, like, so my second match with Mia Yim, she is amazing. So much respect for her. She's such a badass. And so, like, when I found out that I was wrestling her in the second round, I was so hyped because, like, I love her style of wrestling. And, like, I was just, like, so excited. And it was so different for me to come back, like, almost 5 years later and see how much shit had changed. I said to her, I was like, if this is the last time I, like, ever wrestle inside a WWE ring, like, I'd be happy. To come back and have, like, gone through everything I went through and, like, have evolved as much as I did, coming back to the Mae Young and being like, hey, guys, like, check it out. Here's the new me. It was so cool.
So why Mae Young Classic? I mean, you could have chosen, like, Royal Rumble or Evolution.
So, like, I don't know. I had just kind of been putting on social that I was kind of getting back into training again. And because I had gone through this, like, really shitty divorce. And I was like, I love wrestling. Like, let me get back into it to, like, feel like me again. And because I was posting a lot of that on social media, somebody, like, reached out. And they were like, hey, do you want to be a part of this? And, like, I was like, yeah, hell yeah. And then I started training really hard for it because I'm like, I'm not going to go back and suck ass. And, like, and so I trained, like, all summer for it. And the thing with WWE is, like, it's, if you are associated with them, it's such a huge commitment.
Yeah.
And so, like, I have a business and, like, a ton of other stuff going on. So couldn't necessarily commit to, like, a 300-day a year type of, like, schedule.
Yeah.
But, like, to go back and just do this, like, one-off. I think I was there for a week doing, like, press and all that stuff. It was just cool to be back in that world again and it be on my terms. That actually kind of, like, sparked a bunch of, like, some of the wrestling stuff I'm doing now.
And now you're a champion.
Yeah, I'm a champ right here. Like, this, God, it's so heavy. I promise. Ooh. I work out. I am the women's champion of Slam Force Africa.
Yes!
The promoter, his name is Cornelius, and Justin Gabriel, a.k.a. PJ Black, who's associated with it. We've stayed friends all these years, and he was there when I was in WWE. And so they're starting this promotion in South Africa and, like, trying to, like, have this resurgence for pro wrestling there. And like, when they asked me to be part of it, I was like, hell yeah, because like, it's so nice as like a wrestler or like a talent to go and like have your opinions be heard and like respected and like we're literally building it from the ground up. So like having this title is so meaningful because like it's like I'm not just there to hold a title and be a face. It's like they want to know like what creatively what I want to do and like it's awesome. So everything I'm doing now in wrestling is like way more like on my terms and my voice and like. To me, there's nothing cooler than that.
Well, thank you so much for doing Top 5 Moment with
us. Dude, yes.
Is there one thing that you want to tell your fans?
Wow. I just want to say thank you to everybody. Because, like, wrestling fans are the best f***ing fans out there because you guys are so loyal. And, like, just like I love coming to, like, events like this. But I just want to say thank you for, like, following me from day one and then, like, not thinking I was a complete loser for NXT. And then just like being so supportive for like my comeback and everything like that. Like it's so cool to have that support from you guys. So thank you.
One last question. Hire or spin the bottle? Which one do you like?
Dude, I don't like either of them. I never liked either of them.
Spin the bottle's my favorite.
God, like it's your favorite because it's so cringy, right?
Spin the bottle.
So bad. Okay. So bad.